Y'all come on in here. Y'all got to hear this. Drea went on to a podcast and they had asked her, how does she feel about Megan Thee Stallion and Tory Lanez? What does she feel like happened between the two? So this chick real life compared them to Whitney and Bobby, but on top of that, she romanticized the whole situation and said that she wished somebody loved her that much to try to shoot her in the foot as she's getting out the car. Check out this dumbass statement.
Yeah. I predict.
I'll take it.
I predict that they had some sort of Bobby and Whitney love that, you know, drove them down this snapped-esque type of road. And I'm here for it. I like that. I want you to like me so much you shoot me in the foot too. Like,
but as long as...
What the... Whoa!
Wait, no, that is very Drea-like.
Drop a grenade. What the... You want you what?
I want you to like me so much that if I'm trying to get out the car and you're like, no, sit your ass in the car. And I'm like, no, I'm... out the car. No, you're not.
He shoots you in the foot. Wow. Yeah. You gonna fuck.
No, I'm not going
in
nowhere.
This moment?
Yeah, she really said that. So Meg responded back to her. So Meg said, dumb chick, that ain't funny. Who jokes about getting shot by a dude? Then she says, and F all the whole ass dudes making jokes about it too. I'll talk about stuff when I'm ready. So Drea did try to explain herself and apologize. So Drea said, it was a prediction, guys. I have no idea what really happened, and I hope nothing but the best for both of them. And I really shouldn't have been joking about it. It's a foul for me. So I don't care how much she says. It seems like she's losing jobs already. This chick on Twitter says, I can't believe Savage Times Finney hires women who encourage and support abusive, violent relationships. So Savage Times Fenty by Rihanna said, we've been made aware of this. Thank you. So I guess that's cue for... And you know what? That's what she get. It's crazy how many people think this is funny. From 50 Cent to Cameron. So Cameron posted a post that said, Tory Lanez saw that D and started shooting. I don't care what no one says. And he commented and said, the net wins again. So Saucy Santana came out to defend Meg and he said, I don't speak on everything. I mind my business and hope the best for people. Y'all please leave the stallion alone. I was in that situation once. Y'all always trying to piece some stuff together. Let people deal with their issues. It will be addressed, if addressed when needed. First of all, let me say, as a person that have experienced some form of domestic violence within my past, let me say that it is nothing cute, nothing romantic about a man putting his hands on you, pulling out a weapon or anything. It is not cute for anybody to sit here and show some kind of obsessive and abusive traits or, you know, feelings and emotions towards you. It's nothing cute about it. It does not mean that the guy is in love with you. In fact, it just means that he wants to control you. He just sees you as some kind of property and he wants to control you as if you're a thing rather than being a person. And it is the most frustrating thing when you deal with people that either joke about the situation or either try to tell you that it didn't happen. And in Megan's case, you know, by what happened to her being in the public eye, everybody's joking about it. Well, I'm not going to say everybody, but people like 50 Cent, which I don't really expect much from 50 Cent. But dang, like from Cameron and so many other people that are sitting back, and Drea sitting back joking about it and romanticizing the situation and saying that she wishes that someone quote unquote loved her that much is sickening. And these aren't people that are like teenagers or in their early 20s. These are like fully grown ass adults, like people in their late 30s, early 40s, that is making jokes about like domestic violence, and that is so immature, even at the age that she is, to sit here and say, I wish someone loved me that much to the point when I'm trying to get out of the car and they do that to me. And even if she was just trying to be funny, you know, to make someone laugh, that's not funny, okay? People real life deal with situations like that on a day-to-day basis. People real life dealt with situations like that. People are traumatized from that, healing from that, have healed from that. And I highly doubt they feel like that person was so in love with them that they showed some form of violence towards them. I highly doubt that. So I want to say, anybody that's watching my video, you know, if anyone, male or female, is putting their hands on you, is showing some kind of obsessive and weird emotions and, you know, towards you, that does not mean they love you. That is not a sign of love. In fact, that is a sign that you need to let that person go immediately, okay? Just because a guy choke you up, he tell you to sit your ass down, or whatever the case may be, or just because a female, you know, she put her hands on you or whatever like that, does not mean that person loves you. That person is just trying to control you. And when you're getting out of that person's control, or when you have gotten out of that person's control, that person tries to resort to violence because they're sick in the head. It's nothing cute. It's nothing funny about it. You know, it really isn't. So anyways, you guys, let me know what you think down below in the comments, and drop a purple heart for me down in the comments if you've in fact dealt with domestic violence, or if you're just simply against domestic violence. All right, y'all. Peace.